In this lab demonstration, we'll be looking at BigQuery Authorized Views. When using BigQuery, permissions are normally configured at the dataset level. But frequently, data engineering teams will maintain datasets with many large tables of raw data, but then want to share subsets of these tables with particular analyst audiences. For example, analysts might have access to a version of a table that excludes columns with user-specific information. Or perhaps a specific user should be able to see only specific rows from a given BigQuery table or view. So the objectives of this demonstration are to set some permissions on BigQuery datasets. We'll use authorized views to provide audiences with read-only access to subsets of tables, and we'll use the session user function to limit access to specific rows within a table or view. So first, I'll create a dataset for my source data. Then I'll load some source data from cloud storage into a new table in my dataset using the bqload command. I can see my new events table in the BigQuery Explorer, and I can preview the rows in my table. This table has simulated data relating to events generated by users of a video conferencing application. Note that each row has information about the user who generated the event. Later in this demonstration, we'll show how we can restrict results to the session username of the current logged in user. To make sure this works, we'll update some rows in the table with another username from my lab. Next, we'll create the analyst dataset, we'll create a redacted view for the analysts, and we'll create a second view for logged in users. First, I'll create a query that gets event data, but excludes user-specific information. I can now save this query as a view. I'm going to save the view in the Analyst Views dataset, and I'll name the view No User Info. Note that even though the UI calls this a destination table, we're still actually just creating a view. I can see the view in the Analyst Views dataset in the BigQuery Explorer. I can query the view here, and I should be able to see event data results, but without any user data. Now I'll create a second view, which will only show rows for the logged in user. I can do this with the session user function. This view will allow users to see their own events, but no one else's. So there are no events for my current user, but when I use this view as another user in a moment, I should see those rows that I updated earlier. I'll save this view in the Analyst Views dataset, and I'll call this one Row Filter Session User. So now I'm going to share my Analyst Views dataset with my second user. I'll do this by adding a principle. And providing them with the BigQuery data viewer role. Now I need to secure my source dataset. I've shared my analyst views dataset, but I don't want anyone else outside my team having access to the raw data available in the source dataset, so I'm going to restrict access to it. I do want those using the views I've created to be able to see the data the views produce, so this means I must authorize not the users, but the views themselves. So let's edit the authorized views of the source data dataset. I'll select the no user info view that I created a moment ago, and then click add authorization. Then I'll do the same for my row filter session user view. Finally, I need to remove the data viewer permissions from my source dataset. Now I'll test the security settings that I've set up. So here I'm logged into BigQuery as the second user. First, I'll verify that I can run queries against the no user info view. And this query has run successfully. Next, I'll check that I can query the row filter session user view, which should only show me rows associated with my own account. And that works as well. This row filtering view gets the current session user's email address and uses that to filter the rows visible. So every user that queries this view will get different results. Finally, let's see if I can access the source dataset that I restricted. Before I even run the query, I can see an access denied message indicating that I don't have permissions. Remember, this second user has permissions to view tables and views in the analyst views dataset, but does not have permissions to do anything in the source data dataset. When I query the view itself has permissions necessary to operate against the table in the source data dataset, and then it returns that data to the user. That concludes this lab demonstration.